Good morning, students. As in my previous classes, we have gone for carbon and its compounds, right? And after we went to metals and non-metals. So now this we have studied what is metals and what is non-metals. But the thing is that we should know that what it belongs to, from where we got it, how it has been arranged. As we are studying about metals, chemical properties, physical properties. So the thing is that more to know that how we are able to understand that what it considered about it. So for that we are going to study today about periodic classification of elements. Now this word periods. Now what it's tell us that periodic. Simply it tell us how we are arranging the elements and how we are classifying it out, right? Like suppose we have gone for carbon, we have gone for nitrogen, we have studied about magnesium, so many metals like chlorine, non-metals are there. So according to that means we have to know about the periodic, how it has been arranged. So periodic is, we can say it's the arrangement and how we classify the elements. Now to know about this particular word or to know about the arranging of elements, so many people have been given their effort. Like first it was by Daubernier. Daubernier trials. Now what this particular is about is, this person say that the atomic number, for example, he have taken lithium, he have taken nitrogen, he have taken potassium, right? Or many some other like that. He have taken like sodium, he has taken lithium. So he said that according to that, his intention was that taking of any three elements, he want to prove that taking of any three elements, mid of the elements show the medium of that particular atomic mass. For example, he have taken lithium. So we know maybe we have taken lithium, its atomic number is 7. Then he have taken sodium. Sodium we say it's 23, as we know it about. But the thing is that he was trying to take out the atomic mass of the mid of the particular element. Then he take that potassium. Okay, now what he said that taking this three term, he will be finding the mid of this particular element. But it was also failed. Because why it's so? Somehow like we are doing additions, okay, we are going for increasing order, we are going for decreasing order. But sometimes what happened, somewhere we get a criteria, means somewhere we get to fail for that we are not able to take out. Like we know about, we do balance, as we have studied about balancing equation. So somewhere it is very easy to get to balance, but sometime it is not, we are not able to balance. So we call it a skeletal reaction. Similar here, Daubernier, what he thought that by doing this, he will be arranging the atomic mass in the increasing form. But he also got failed because some of the element he was not able to take out the atomic mass, right? Then after Daubernier, Newland came. Now what was Newland optics? Newland law of octaves. Now this octave seems to be, we say octave, we see it is 8, right? It means that in this law, what Newland want to prove that the arrangement of the elements of the atomic mass, with the help of the atomic mass, he considered the 8th of the element is similar to the first element. He states that the 8th element will be similar to the first element. It was Newland law of octaves. But somehow what happened, he was not able to do with every element which is comparably similar to the first element. So what happened, Newland also got failed. He was not also not able to take this periodic table to a certain point. After Newland, there came Mendeleev. Mendeleev's. Now, Mendeleev's somehow he arranged the periodic table in some certain period. Like first he said, like this is the arrangement of the period. First he said the vertical column. Okay, he mentioned a name of group. So Mendeleev arranged the periodic table in first formation as a vertical column. He mentioned that I will be arranging the atomic number of that particular element in an increasing order. For that, what he has said, let me go through, let me divide the atomic weight according to column or by row. So what he considered, he made group first. So group is the vertical column, and then after he make the horizontal row, that he made as periods. This group he divided into 8, that is from group 1 to group 8. Total group was divided from 1 to 8, but the group also was subdivided. It was having some subdivision. Okay, and the subdivision was from group 1 to group 7. Because 8 he considered, he was not able to make 8 is similar to this particular group. So, he made 8 as a 0 group. Next come the periods. He also divided the period from period 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. He also mentioned the period till 7th. But till the 6th period, it was done that till the 6th period, the elements has been arranged according to the similar or chemical properties of that particular group. But in the 8th group, what happened? It was not known to us. It was not known to us means it was a complete group. Incomplete group it was. So, Mendeleev what actually comparing to Dovernier or Newland, Mendeleev somehow he worked on this periodic classification and he divided group and period so that the elements can be similar, can be explained to us according to their properties, how and the increasing form of their atomic number. Next comes, after Mendeleev, slowly what happened, the periodic table came to an modern. Modern means where we are now being what we are studying now. We came to that group period, we came to know that how it is arranged, how the elements are being arranged. Okay, like for period I am telling. Now we will go for the period. Now listen student, period is that particular period from we come to know that how many elements considered, how many types of electrons. Okay, like first period consider only 2 elements. It consider 2 elements. Then second, it's 8 elements. Third, again it consider 8 elements. Fourth, 18th, 5th, 18th, 6th is 32 elements. So, according to it, the period he divided the elements to their similar property. Now, student, listen, as we have studied in the structure of atom and all, how the elements, how the electron has been shared in the orbitals. Like, suppose we are having one atom here. In the atom, we are having here a small nucleus, right? In the nucleus, we know protons and neutrons are present. But what is the work of this electron which is moving towards its orbits? The work of the electron is to share it, what numbers we are having to share the electrons towards the orbit. So, this is the elements which we can share in particular in this orbits. So, the capacity is that like 2, we can first orbits will be of 2, second will be of 8, third also 8, but not more than these all. Only they have given a capacity of the orbits through the part of that elements. Then we are having 18, then 18 and 32. So, this way what we can do, we can share the electron which are revolving. See students, what we are studying in the periodic classification, we are studying about the elements, we are studying about the atomic number. This number, what we are doing, this number we are just distributing is towards the atomic parts. This is nothing, these all are atoms, these elements all are according to the properties only we are distributing, we are arranging. Like how we are learning that this is metal, this is non-metal, this is metalloids, through the properties only. This particular having shine, this is having ductile, this is non-sonorous, not produce sound. How we are coming to know? Through this periodic classification itself, because in this only we have classified how the elements are being arranged, how they are arranged. They have arranged means we have picked up that this is metals, this is metalloids, this is non-metal, these are the gases. So, a part of that, what you are going to do in my next class, we are going to, I am going to show you how we are arranging the elements according to the electrons. And the meanwhile, what you will do, you will go through the periodic table, like how I have divided the group and how I have divided the period. Okay? Okay. Thank you, students.